Greetings, Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back. Look at my video. I have a question here from a subscriber. Can Candida live inside the gums? I have a stubborn fungal infection in the right side of my throat, and I'm wondering if the yeast infection I have also been battling has gone into my gums. So what can I do about it, please? So it doesn't really matter whether it's a bacterial infection or a fungal infection. There's more chance that it's going to be a bacterial infection because we have many more bacteria in our mouth than yeast, many more. So generally, when you talk to a dental hygienist, they'll talk to you about strep bacteria and different types of bacteria that live in and around the gum. It could be fungal, but fungal tends to be more on the tongue or on the inside surface of the mouth rather than inside the gum. So if it's deep in around the tooth and especially in the roots, it's probably going to be an anaerobic kind of bacteria. So these are bacteria that don't need oxygen to survive. Now, these can be quite tough and hard to eradicate. Many people also that I see have got different forms of antibiotic resistant strep bacteria in their throat. I've seen this on many different tests. So what do you do? What do you do if you've got an infection in the gum? You need to go definitely and go and get a dental inspection done and go to a hygienist to see what she or he can offer in terms of, you know, they'll often do a salivary test or a breath test to look at the type of bacteria and the level of bacteria you've got there, or fungal, if it on that, the off chance that it is a fungus. A couple of suggestions I have would be to rinse your throat, because you're mentioning here right side of my throat. So I would recommend at least twice, if not three times a day, a good gargle with about 8 ounces of water, a couple of good, you know, swigs and gargles with a good quality sea salt, and also a half a teaspoon of colloidal silver. So gargle at least twice, if not three times a day, preferably after meals. You're going to gargle the throat area. I also recommend in the morning oil pulling. Get a tablespoon of oil, for example, an olive oil. Some people use sesame oil, I prefer that. And put that in your mouth upon rising first thing. It may be unpleasant if you haven't done it before, but it's no big deal. Swish it around the mouth for a good 3 or 4 minutes. So let's just say I've got some green tea here. Well, you're not going to swallow it, but I just did. So you need a good tablespoon and you're really going to swish it around the mouth, and you're going to gargle a bit with it and swish it around for a good 2 or 3 minutes. Then you're going to spit it in the waste paper basket, you know, in down the sink or in go to the bathroom, get rid of it. Every morning, do that for about 2 weeks. You watch what happens. It's amazing. It acts like a magnet. It pulls all the bacteria into the oil and then you eject it. So it reduces the oral population of bacteria. Meanwhile, you're gargling and you're cleansing the oral and cavity and throat with water, tepid water with salt and colloidal silver. They'll neutralize and help to cleanse, and the oil pulling will reduce the population. Clever combination. Third tip, grapefruit seed extract. Not grape seed, but grapefruit seed extract. 5 drops in about a tablespoon of water. Again, swish that around your mouth like the oil pulling. Swish, 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 swish all over the place. A little gargle and swish, and then spit that out again. Get rid of it. So you've got the oil pulling in the morning. You've got the throat gargles with salt and colloidal silver 2 times or 3 times per day. You've got the grapefruit seed extract to give it a sucker punch to really get in there. You try those approaches, and then you will usually clear up a throat problem. If not, homeopathy often works well. There are different homeopathic medicines that work on the throat. You could go and see a herbalist, or get a herb like golden seal, for example, or berberine, which are antibiotic. They're going to help. And the last tip is food allergies. Always get checked for food allergies if you've got a very poor, you know, throat and it's not responding. Take dairy products out of the diet. No kefir, no yogurt, no milk, nothing, no cream, no butter, nothing like that at all. All out. You also might want to look at gluten, bananas, eggs. There are a couple of other foods. See some of my videos on allergy foods. I may well have done some videos on that. And last but not least, if you've got recurring sore throat and immune dysfunction, you could have an adrenal gland problem. So you may need to get some salivary cortisol testing done to see if you've got very low cortisol. That could be why your lymphatic system is not amped up enough to nail that infection. Are you getting enough sleep? Could be a lack of sleep, could be stress, could be a lot of stuff. Information overload. I hope that was enough for you, subscriber. Thanks for the question. click on my link below to get the free Candida report if you haven't already done so. Thanks.